Hi, I'm Dr. Jeff McGee. This is Changeformational, the Pulse to Success. I want to challenge us to think about a new concept. It really isn't new, but evidently it must be new when you start to look around the environments you live in. You know, a couple years ago, I wrote a book called Your Trajectory Code. It was a great-selling book with John Wiley Book Publishers. If you're not familiar with it, I encourage you to go buy it. Get a copy on Apple iTunes if you're an audio person. But in the book of Your Trajectory Code, the only personal success book I've written, and out of the 30-plus books I've written, translated into more than 20 different languages, college textbooks, and trade books as well. In Your Trajectory Code, Chapter 13 talks about the power of low expectations. And the power of low expectations is a very dangerous cancer that can be created in a child's life at an early age by all of the influencers around them, playmates, family members, educators, neighborhood employers, all of the people in a child's development from birth to 16, 17, 18 years of age. And then when they go off to college, if they have that luxury, or they go to a trade school or tech school, or maybe they don't go to any other school after high school. And then think about as you continue your own journey, as you're watching this here with us today, think about your own journey post-high school or college age. Again, those jobs you've had, the people you've been around, the associations you've made, the friend groups you've been in and out of, the trade associations you could have been or you are participating in, the power of low expectation. You go out to eat somewhere, they give you crappy service, yet you still give them a tip. You're now rewarding low expectations. You, in essence, tolerate and condone behaviors and actions that never should have been tolerated, low expectations. I don't know. Let me go out on a limb and just make up an example. Let's say we live in a society that has laws, and then we decide that we don't want to reinforce those laws, and so then that triggers people's behaviors that manifest to a level that blows your mind as to what people are doing. It's because of the power of low expectations. Sometimes I hear people talking about elected leaders that are complete train wrecks, and they say, but at least in essence, my life is not that bad. I mean, low expectations. So we have calibrated our entire life. If you start to recognize it, unfortunately, in many cases where low expectations becomes the now norm expectation. So if you want to be change formational, catch yourself. Start with yourself. And recognize all of the places where you really put forth a lower level of performance and capability as opposed to what you know you're capable of. And raise your own performance level up so there now is not that easy catch and I gotcha of you're performing at a low expectation. And when you raise the bar, you will then indirectly recognize that will start to raise the bar on people around you and ask and invite people to be your challenge partner in a constructive way, your accountability partner in a constructive way, your coach, your advisor, your mentor, or any word you want to put on it. I mean, here in our studios of WWDB-TV in Las Vegas, again, our primary owner and station chief, John, is phenomenal at exactly this. He's always raising the low expectation bar up, not allowing the low expectation bar to stay here or go down. Who do you have in your spaces that helps you to keep raising your performance bar? And how do you start to change low expectations? Performance reviews in companies, another example. Are we really using a performance review and accountability review to grow and develop someone and hold them accountable for where they've excelled, where they're performing, or where they're going low? Or do we pass people along? I see in lots of organizations where I come in an advisory role or in a leadership development role where a lot of times performance is actually not happening at a high level in a business. Even when I think it is, a lot of businesses have got comfortable. Comfortable. Comfort is the cancer to success because it puts you on a trajectory of low expectations. Let people become comfortable with raising that bar every day and then see where the fun begins. I'm Jeff McGee and this has been Changeformational.